Okay, I'm gonna do a video of me putting a processor in my Acer. I think it's a 4471. Let me look here. That's why I opened this CPU-Z up. Yeah, Acer 7741 is what it is. It's basically the cheapest 17-inch laptop you could get from Acer. And right now, it has a Pentium in it. And here's the hardware specs. You know, I really think the one that's going to increase is the processor. I don't think the RAM's going to jump up. I think it'll run at the same speed. But I think the processor will jump into the 6s, 6.6, 6.8, somewhere around there. Because I got the i5 from my Alienware that I took out, the 520M. So I'm going to take this guy all apart. Let me just go over the baselines here. I don't think the graphics is going to jump. If anything, the Aero graphics might jump up to maybe 5. Because I think that's really determined by the access speed. So if I go back down here to CPU-Z, and actually, if you'll notice, it's got the same Southbridge HM55 that my Alienware has. So what I got in there right now is the Pentium 6100 2 gigahertz. It's actually the TDP is the same. The 25 watts. That's exactly what this 520 is. So I'm hoping to get a jump on that core speed. I'm also going to get a jump on my level 3 cache. I'll also get two more threads because the i5 has hyper-threading. So I think that's a big boost. What I'd like to get, see it says Intel HD graphics. I'd like to get the HD 2000 or 3000, but I don't think that 520 has that one in there. I think that it only has the same graphics, but I think that it has a higher clock speed. Or did I type that wrong? It should be able to give me... Let's check it, just for giggles. While I'm here... GPU... While we wait... Okay, so it says my graphics is running at 373 megahertz for the core clock. That's just kind of a reference. See my bandwidth, 17. And it has DDR3, which is really based on the RAM speed that I have, since there is no actual graphics memory. But I do have an extra 4 gigs of RAM. This has only got 3 in it, so I need to get a boost to my ability to play high-def video. When I watch high-def video on here, there's kind of a lag, especially when I'm streaming it, when it streams fine on my Alienware. So I'm hoping this 520 does it. So I'm just going to get a kind of an idea of, here's my GPU speeds. I think it actually has the same GPU core, but it contains the ability to overclock the same way the i5 can overclock from 2.5 gigahertz to 3 when only one core is being used. So I'm gonna post, you'll see me putting the video of this thing, taking this thing all apart. I hope it actually works when I put it back together. And then we'll do a follow-up video afterwards. Okay, this is probably as good as the lighting is going to get. So I'm just going to start taking this apart. And I'm actually just going to record it in case I need anything. To, you know, remember where I put stuff or something like that. I won't bore everybody with the complete disassembly unless it's just really, really interesting. So... bear with me while I take this apart. Okay, I got the hard drive out. One thing that I do want to note is the white one goes here, the black one goes here. Is that blurry? Should focus. Strange. Okay. Just to let you know where I'm at, I got the keyboard out, and that consisted of these little tabs. Tab there, tab there, tab there, tab there, tab there. I pushed those tabs in with a little flat-headed screwdriver. The keyboard lifted out, and I disconnected this ribbon cable right here. So there's the keyboard. There were 5 screws underneath it. Right there, and then all these screws were the screws on the bottom, and then these screws came from the battery tray area, and then one from the hard drive, which is right there. and I've got it cracked loose. So I'm gonna put this camera back on the rack and very slowly lift up on this thing and see where it's hung at. There's a little ribbon cable there, which I think probably controls the power switch right here. When I lift it up, this ribbon cable underneath right here probably controls the trackpad. So I'll probably have to disconnect those, and then I'll be back with an update. I wonder if I can just take the plastic off the bottom. This probably runs. The connection for the screen, maybe. I don't know. I wonder if I can just take it off the bottom, because I don't really need to take this off if I don't have to. Okay, I went ahead and I disconnected the ribbon cable right here, the ribbon cable right here, and then the small ribbon cable right there, and this tray came off. I think there are only, and I'm going to set this tray over here. I think there are only a couple screws holding this motherboard in. Now what it looks like right here, I wonder if I can zoom in and get what I want. Here's the video, here's the cable that connects the video screen. And that screen is really heavy right now, since there's nothing in there to hold it up. I think that if I just... I think I only have one screw holding this guy in. Because this is the part that needs to flip over. Yeah, I don't think that's the only one. I bet you if I take this guy out... Looks like I got a little... There's a little... This little daughter board right here. I don't know if you can see it. There's a little daughter board right there. Yeah. The processor's right underneath there. And that's what I need to get to. Now I think I have to disconnect this guy, because this video's not going to turn out very well. This is a daughter board that controls the USB and card readers. Okay. I should be able to flip. Now this is the LCD cable, which is right here. They both plug into there. I think I should be able to... The only thing that I really have to make sure is that I make sure I push that guy back in real secure. Because if I don't, I'm going to have to take it all apart. This guy should really be ready to flip over. And here's the motherboard. And then there's this. It's really flimsy. It's a DC connector. Well, I don't mind pulling it out, but I don't want to damage the cables. It's a lot of work for something that's just right there, isn't it? I wonder if I can do this without breaking everything apart. Because that's a really flimsy part of the motherboard. That's something I should really disconnect with it mounted somewhere. I wonder if I can pull this guy out of the case. That would be easier. Of course, it's taped down. Okay, so what I did is I just lift, instead of disconnecting the DC adapter, I just lifted it out. I'm just going to scooch this guy back. Hopefully I won't do anything that destroys this all apart, because that would suck. I mean, I don't have a lot of money. I got about $300 in it, but even so. Okay. Let's see if I can get this on camera since this is the money shot. Okay, so here is the heatsink cooler. Looks like there's three screws holding it down. That's a tiny little motherboard. Looks like I got two. I got this one, and then I got this one over here. So I'm probably gonna have to use two thermal pastes because I got four screws that hold this down. Things made by Foxconn these days. Well, let's see. Loose. Where else are you held in at? I don't see anything. And there it goes. Yeah, it just looked right off. Beautiful. Okay. You gonna focus? No focus? Okay. Well, it looks like the Northbridge chip, this guy right here, has some heat thermal tape on it, so as long as I put it back on there, I should be okay. And here's the Pentium. I wonder if it says Pentium on it. It says P6100 right there. So, and it's got some tape. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean this heatsink up and put my thermal compound on there. I'll go get the other processor and we'll do a double shot of it. Okay, so here's the i5-520 versus the Pentium. They actually aren't too much different, besides the fact that one of them's upside down. I don't know if I can get close enough for us to see the skew. Intel 520M. Pentium 6100. So I'm gonna clean this guy off, stick it in here, and we'll put it all back together and hopefully it'll work. Okay, shockingly, I actually got it back together with no parts left over, so I'm gonna boot it up for the first time on battery. It's a good sign. No beeps yet. Ooh, starting Windows. No explosions. No smoke. This could be a first. I need to clean that screen off. I wonder if my graphics driver will be all messed up. Like it was on the Alienware. No? It says please wait, welcome. That bugs me. I need to clean this thing. It actually looks perfect. Ooh, new devices. Let's take a look at these new devices. Let's go properties. Restart later. Ooh, it says i5. 2.4 gigahertz. Let's see if I got a new video. Let's just take a look here. Oh, yeah. C-Money. Let's do CPU first. Okay, this is just an initial. Maybe if I can get that clicking. It's hard to click. Reading. Ooh. 2.4. Yeah, it looks like it worked. Looks like I got four threads. It's running it, you know, perfectly. It's running one core, 2.9 gigahertz. That's beautiful. I don't think the graphics are going to be any better. Yeah, it still says just HD graphics. Let's see if I got any more clock rate on that guy. Actually, I can just click this. It's hard to do left-handed. GPU-Z. No, it still says the same. It doesn't really look any different. It's 17 gigabits per second. But should be able to overclock if everything's going well. I don't know. I'm going to go ahead and reboot it a couple times, but it looks like it was successful. Very, very painless. Definitely a lot less painless than doing that Alienware, even though technically I have to take apart less on the Alienware. This actually went perfectly. I can't seem to do a whole video without getting buzzed on my phone, can I? Sensors, 1%. It's only using 50 megs of video, probably because I haven't done anything yet. Let's see where the CPU-Z is at. Main board looks the same. Looks the same. Says I got 4 threads now, so let's verify that. Task manager. Ooh, look at that. 4 threads. Cool. So I'm actually going to have to plug it in to rerun my Windows evaluation. So I'm going to go ahead and reboot it a couple times and plug it in. And I'll rerun the process and show you my new scores. If you'll notice, you can't run the Windows experience while on batteries, but I hope to get that processor up to 6-ish, and maybe that graphics will boost up to from 3. I don't know. I'm going to go ahead and plug it in and run the Windows experience again. Well, there's nothing quite like results. After all that work, you'd like to see some success, right? Well, my graphics score did jump up to 4.3, which I didn't think that it would, which might be a factor of the fact that this i5 can actually overclock the graphics core, which my processor did jump up to 6.8. It's exactly what it was when it was in the Alienware. I also went ahead and put in the 4 gigs of RAM that I took out of my Alienware because I upgraded it to 8. So I got a boost in performance, and I'm very happy. So I guess that's a result. And it actually went easier than my Alienware did, surprisingly, even though there was more stuff to take apart.